Jang Bamavar Nindaru Damaruto Stunbanti di Hibbaistavahi Bedei Sanga Padakramo Panishadai Gayanti Yam Samaga Dhanavastita Tadagati Namanasa Paspanti Yam Yogina Yasantana Viduhu Sura Suragana Devayata Asmai Nama Jang Brahma Barunendaru Damaruto Sunmanti Dehibhaistavai Bedai Sangha Padakramo Panishadai Gayanti Yam Samaga Dhanavastita Tadigati Namanaswa Paspanti Yam Yogina Yasam tamna viduhu sura suragana devayuta asmai namaha. Gaudiya Goshtipati, Sisilo Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, if you can match your desire with the desire of Supreme Lord, then and only then you can become happy. Gauriya Goshtipati, Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, if you can match your desire with the desire of Supreme Lord, only then and then you can become happy. Otherwise, never you can become happy. Some group always shouting about private happiness. Some group always shouting about private happiness. Another group there, they are shouting about public happiness. We Gauriya Vaishnava, we Vaishnava are less interested about both of this formula. Prabhupada speaking, some group they are shouting from private happiness. Another group starting for public happiness. We are neither interested about private happiness, nor we are interested about public happiness. We are interested about the happiness of Supreme Lord. We are always interested about the happiness of Supreme Lord. That is the topmost secret formula. We devotees always trying to seek the satisfaction of Supreme Lord all the time. All the time we are trying to seek the satisfaction of Supreme Lord. Total satisfaction, not satisfaction. We are always seeking the satisfaction of we are going to seek the happiness, private happiness, nor going to seek the public happiness. We are always seeking, interested or going to seeking the happiness of Supreme Lord all the 24 hours, whole life, total satisfaction. That is the desire of pure devotees. Common people, they cannot have that kind of mood, because always they have some private interest. Also, they are going to show some interest for Gurudev. We are doing something for Gurudev. Actually, point is that bonded soul always try to serve Guru Vishnu Bhagavan. They want to get some return. They want to get some salary. Or if not salary, whole life doing some service of Gurudev, after some time they want to get pension. Pension, you know? Pension. This is the situation of bonded soul. This is the poor situation, painful, miserable situation of bonded soul. They cannot make any head and tail of what is called actual pure bhajan. All contaminated. Whole situation contaminated. Nobody want to speak about that absolute truth, to point out this is pure bhakti, this is not pure bhakti. This is one kind of enjoyment. Foolish people, they don't understand. One very rich people, he is going to put the picture of Kaliya Daman, picture in the room, wall painting, very nice. Foolish people, if they watch, they say, he's a great devotee. Why painting nice picture of Radha, Govindo, Kaliyadaham, nice. Pope speaking, they are idiot, foolish, they don't understand. That rich people going to put this picture of Krishna, not out of devotion, is one kind of indriyotarpan, you know, indriyotarpan, sensual enjoyment. Morning time I can get up, take coffee and watch the picture of Krishna. Very nice. Radha Govinda. And I have passive calm inside my body, mind. I can support that with the help of that picture. Very nice. Foolish people don't understand. Pure devotion, not a matter of joke. Pure devotion, not a matter of joke. If you can give your whole life, if you can dedicate your whole life for the cause of Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan, still you cannot say, I am doing bhakti. Because those who are doing actual pure devotion, running into the in the marg of pure marg, I mean path of pure devotion, they never deserve that we are doing bhajan. Like Rupa Sanatam, Raghunath, Gopal Bhatto, Jiva Goswami Pat. They never speak like that. Actually, I was speaking about the free will of Jivatma. Be careful, I can touch something here. But main, I will have to discuss the topics of Jiva Goswami for a little bit, because time is limited, and the topics of Jagadish Pandit. Is a Tirobhav Tithi. This April's day, I must touch to purify myself. So somehow I can touch this point and switch over to that point. That what is the Siddhanta of Jiva Goswami Path, I can touch and speak about them. I was speaking about the free will of Jivatma. All countless Jivas, they have their free will. And also I pointed out from Gita that Krishna speaking to Arjuna, Supreme Lord is not at all responsible for the situation they are creating in their life. I mean those bonded souls. They are going to put themselves in miserable situation, painful situation. They want to enjoy. So it is their ultimate goal. So they are going to put themselves in trouble. And they point out the Supreme Lord is responsible for our this kind of miserable situation, not that actually. Krishna already speaking in Gita, I already point out, Nadatte kasachit papam na chaiva sukritim vibhum agyanena avritam jnanam tena muhyanti yantavaha. Thus bonded soul, they are in maya, covering up maya there. So they are confused, they are in confusion. They cannot understand what is actual bliss, enjoyment. They don't understand. So they are going to create some miserable situation in which they are going to put themselves. So Supreme Lord is not responsible. Supreme Lord always calling them, Madhjaji Mang Namaskuru. You only and only worship me and pay dandavat to me. And it is my standing commitment that I am going to save you. I am going to save you. I have a standing commitment. ma sucho vaham tvam sarva papibhyo mokshayishami ma sucho. It is my standing commitment that I can save you, I promise you. And the name of Supreme Lord is Satyabrata. Always speaking. The feature of Supreme Lord is absolute truth. So, Aham Tvam Sarva Papibhyo Mokshayishami Ma Sucho. You need not repent, you need not cry. You need not cry. So I am going to save you. And no demigods going to this kind of, put this kind of commitment. Anunnas chintayanto ye yanamang parjupasati tesam nityabhi yuktanam yogokhyama bahamyaham bahamyaham bahami aham. It is a standing commitment of Supreme Lord Krishna that I am going to give you full protection. Protection about what? You have some property, you have any property with your real self, I can give protection. At the same time, whatever you have in this material life, also I am going to protect you. Whatever you have in your life, maybe spiritual property or material, any property. Sometime Krishna going to play with devotees to bring him into the path of pure devotion, as a special case. Actually, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, that I am going to give full protection, provided you are totally dedicated to me. If you are 100% dedicated to me, totally devoted to me, be sure then I am going to give you full protection. One or two examples I can give to you. You can remember the case of Pancha Pandav, you know. What the situation? You cannot stand if you hear the miserable situation of Pancha Pandav. But never in whole life Pancha Pandav not going to speak that we love Krishna, then why were you in this kind of miserable situation? Draupadi not going to speak, why? I am Krishna speaking, Krishna is my friend, but why I am in this kind of situation? My son gone. Huh? Five son. Okay? And, also, you know, the name of that, Abhimanyu also gone. This way, you cannot point out one single instant. When they become very angry, when they are feeling disturbance, why we are going to love Krishna, but why we are in trouble? They are not speaking. They are not speaking that way. Because they always think, whatever happening in my life, all for good. Follow. Whatever happening in my life, all for good. That bonded soul cannot realize. Not a matter of joke. Whatever happening in my life, all for my good. You cannot realize this point. Not a matter of joke. Only pure devotee can understand. Those who have that kind of, you know, topmost, you know, intelligence, spiritually intelligent, they can realize it's all for my good. Brahma was bound to speak that way. I already told many times. Brahma was bound to speak that way. Tathe anukampam susamekshamanam bhunyana eva atmakrita vipakam hrid bhagva pavir vidadad namaste jiveto muktipade or bhaktipade sadhayapak. Brahma and also Kunti Devi speaking. Hey Supreme Lord, we want to get trouble from you, problem. If we are in problem, all around problem and inside, in between I am in problem, then I can have constant remembrance. I can continuously remember you. If you are going to allow me in a very suitable position, then I can forget. I can sleep and drink and nice enjoyment, then I can forget you. If you put him in trouble, then I can remember you continuously. Ho Prabhu. This is the situation. Pure devotees are always speaking. So, if you are going to do so 100% devotion, 100%, then it is a duty of Krishna. I mean, standing commitment of Krishna. Krishna speaking, I am going to protect everything, what all you have, what you all have in your life, and what you like to get in your life, all I can give full protection. Hello? Joga kshema bahami. Joga means what you want to get, I mean, for seva. Kshema, actually, what you have, what you don't have, all responsibility Krishna can take, all responsibility. But bonded soul don't like to believe this point. They are always standing on their purushakar. Purushakar, you know, in Sanskrit we say, purushakar means own power. I am powerful, I am intelligent, I am educated, I have money. This is called purushakar. Purushakar means he is going to believe themselves. They are not going to believe. They are always busy with their own power, money power, man power, everything. That is called own purushakar. Have some false ego. That's why they are always misguided. Supreme Lord has nothing to do with that. Now point can come, one point, that why, if Supreme Lord is the supreme controller, Supreme Lord can easily control the situation, and Supreme Lord can change their mood. Why not changing their mood? They can start devotion. Supreme Lord can do it. So they need not, you know, suffer. Point is that, is one kind of game. Is one kind of game going on, like two small boys, they are making two teams. They are making two teams, they are playing with one, we all, the small boys. We are playing with each other. This is one kind of playing. Krishna always playing with all infinity Jivatma. Is one kind of vast ras. Krishna doing rasa with Satakoti Gopika, you heard. But here, Krishna not dancing with Satakoti Gopika. Krishna doing rasa with infinity world, infinity Jivatma. Is one in greater sense. Actually, I'm actually going to give you some idea. Is also in one sense. Actually, rasa is that, because rasa coming. But this is one kind of mood, nice. That for infinity period, infinity Jivatma, and Krishna playing with them. Krishna watching what they want to do. Let them do. Again they fall down, again Krishna help them, come up. This way, one, it is also one kind of vast, you know, playing, going on. Actually, rasa means rasa. But here actually Krishna already getting some kind of, you know, enjoyment, rasa, while playing with all jivas. If Krishna going to take control over their free will, then the game is not, perfect. Follow what I say. If Krishna going to take control over their free will, then the game is not perfect. Follow what I say. Then one kind of pressure Krishna going to put them. Hey, you come to me. No, Krishna don't like. Krishna never want to. Krishna want to give them free will at the same time, Krishna want to see that I am giving you this property, free will, how best possible way you can utilize it. I am giving you this property. Property means free will. I am giving you this property to you. How best possible way you can utilize it, let me see. You don't like to come to me? Okay, you don't like to come to me. I cannot put pressure on you. If I put pressure on you, then it is not game. Follow. If Krishna is going to put pressure on them, is not actually playing. Is one kind of atrocity. Atrocity, you know? It's one kind of atrocity. Hey, you have to obey me. Hey, come to me. Krishna don't want to do. Krishna want to give free will to them. Krishna want to say, let me see how best possible way you can utilize it. If you like to come to me, if you don't like to come anyway, infinity world, infinity jivatma in infinity world, knowingly or unknowingly they are serving Krishna anyway. Serving, na? Those who are in Maya, they are also serving, but indirect way. Follow. Directly or indirectly, all they are somehow doing some service for Krishna. Knowingly or unknowingly. A farmer growing paddy field, he is thinking, I can grow paddy and sell in market, I can maintain my family. But anyway, if you watch, then those paddy, some, you know, bonders are going to buy, I mean rice, you know, cooking. This way, whole infinity world is one kind of, you know, whole jivatma. Knowingly or unknowingly, they are doing some service for Krishna. Police department also doing some service for Krishna, unknowingly. And those who are thieves and dacoits and hooligans, they are also indirectly doing some seva for Krishna. This one kind of acting, you know, theater, drama going on. Oh, it's one kind of dream or drama. All while you are playing in the form of father, he is playing the role in the form of son, she is playing the role of mother, but how long? For certain period. Suppose he took birth when she was only 22, now if he is 45, he will have to calculate how long he is going to identify, how long he is going to identify that she is my mother. How long she is going to identify that he is my son? All limited. You must be intelligent enough to understand that we all are in relative world. This relativity, if this question of relativity at all coming inside your heart, direct feeling of relativity, whole relative world, nothing permanent. Oh, relative, nothing permanent. Only Krishna is my friend. Krishna is my friend. So all the time, tameva mata chapita tameva tameva vandus cha sakha tameva tameva vidvam davinam tameva tameva sarvam mama deva deva. You cannot believe it. She is your mother, you are going to depend. You are not going to depend on mother. You are going to depend on bank account, bank money. I have this deposit knife. Anytime those government can take decisions so that you are going to get minimum interest. Government now going to take decision to reduce the, you know, percentage of. So those who are going to keep 50 lakhs in bank, they are going to very minimum amount. They cannot maintain their life. And also in foreign country, those countrymen, they are going to pay money to bank that you are taking care of my money. in foreign country. Some, so this way anytime situation can change, you can feel problem in your life, but be careful, all relative situation, relative world. Always try to feel that you are in relative world. I can give one example so that you can understand that what is called relativity. How you can understand that there is a relative situation, relative world. I am giving one example, you can understand. Suppose one train, Hikari Express, going this direction, north direction, at the velocity of 200 kilometers per hour. Try to understand this point. 200 kilometers per hour, this way, north direction. Same track, parallel track. Hikari Express. And another train going same direction, follow, bullet train in Japan. So this train going 200 kilometer per hour velocity, this was 12, same direction. Perhaps you have, you know, seen this point. If two train going parallel, same velocity, from one train to another train, if you see, you can see both stand still, right? Follow, you watch. Two train going same velocity, then from one train, you are watching another train, you can see stand still, not going. Follow. So the relative velocity of bullet train with respect to Hikari Express, zero. Relative velocity, not actual velocity. For the same reference frame, as per physics, for the same reference frame, velocity of bullet train with respect to that train, Hikari Express, is now zero. For the time being, with relative to this time, this and that. But this is not actually. If you watch another window, you are watching this window, this train going. If you watch another window, you can find 200 km train running. But if you watch this train, from here, you can find all standstill. It's called relative. And if just opposite thing happening, I mean the Hikari Express going north direction, 200 kilometers per hour velocity, and bullet train coming just opposite direction, opposite, is going this and this going. If you are going to watch one train from another, suppose you are in bullet train, you are going to watch that Hikari Express. You can find almost you cannot see anything. Shh, gone. Like dream, 200 kilometers you see, not 200 kilometers, at present 10 going 400 kilometers per hour, 500 kilometers per hour, 600 kilometers per hour, in France, here, there, discovered, more than the velocity of plane, oh, so fast, magnetic power, track is there, but rolling, magnetic field. Magnetic power. So now, if they are going opposite direction, now the velocity of bullet train with respect to Hikari Express is 400 kilometers per hour. Follow. 200 this way going, 200 this way. Two and two if you add, 400 per one velocity of another one train with respect to another is now 400 km, almost you cannot see, like dream, gone. This is called relativity. But this is not actually true. You are in this room, she is mother, is your father, this, that, this situation is created. All one kind of drama. is your grandson, you are going to take in lap, kiss, you are getting some sort of enjoyment. But you don't know, this enjoyment can put you in trouble. Because you are going to make link with that baby. Unnecessarily, unstable. Whereas you know that the relation I have grown in this life with son, father, mother, wife, all temporary. You are going to make some unstable relation with the baby, and while you are going to die, you can cry for that baby. Oh, where is this baby? Then you will have to take birth in the form of that baby. When grow up, you will have to come in the form of son or daughter of that baby. Jang jang ba opi saranam bhavam tajati ante kalevaram. At the time of your death, what you are thinking, you have to get. Don't try to grow enmity with anybody. Don't try to get grow any false relation with anybody. Don't try to grow any, you know, hatred. It's dangerous for you. It can put you in this material world, cannot allow you to enter into Vaikuntha Jagat. One example if I give, you can understand. Bonded soul, what is the situation of bonded soul? One small baby, very small, 2, 3 years, 4 years, and father arranged one small pet dog, you know, lollipop from Bhutan. Very nice, all far there, you can take in lap and kiss. And people kissing dog, they become dog in the next life. Follow? If you are going to grow relationship with one dog, then next time you will have to take birth as dog. As per scriptural and scientific document, not false. I am not speaking any false philosophy. 100% scientific. Many such evidence I can give you. Whatever you think, at the time of your death, you will have to take birth in this form. So now the small boy, father, small, very small baby, arrange one small dog, all the time playing with the dog, sometime reading, going to school. Someday that small, that lollipop, I mean that dog, die. Some disease happen. And, you know, the maid servant going to take that small boy from school to collect him and speaking, your Tommy die. The small boy don't understand. He has no direct feeling of what is death, and he don't understand. You also don't have any feeling about what is called death. You know, death, you know, someday I will have to die. But you have not any direct feeling about what is called death. If you can feel now what is called death, instant you can stop all nonsense. You can only cry for Krishna. Like, you know, Khatanga Raja going to help those demigods, Indra, Varun, everybody. Demigods, because the fighting going between Asura and Sura, demon and those who are staying in heavenly planet, I mean those Indra, Varun, those devata, demigods fighting. They are not in a position to come out, you know, successful. Then invite Khatanga Raja. Could you help us? Yes, we can. Khatanga Raja is so powerful, fighting, and all demigods, the team of, they come out successful. Demigod usually have their power to bless you. Oh, Khatanga Raja, we are very happy with you. Because you are going to help us in our, you help us to get victory. What do you want? We can bless you. Anything you want. Khatanga is speaking, let me know, let me first know how long I am going to live. Let me know how long I am going to live, then I can ask benediction from you. The demigod can see everything, past, present and future. Oh, your life is very short. Only 48 minutes you are going to... Huh? 48 minutes? Yes. Very shortly you are going to die. Then I don't want any benediction. You all demigods, you bless me so that I can concentrate my mind unto the lotus feet of Krishna. That is sufficient. I don't want. Okay. Then within 48 minutes, Khatanga Raja was successful. Khatanga Raja was successful within 45 minutes. Within 7 days, Parikshit Maharaj was successful. Within 7 days, Parikshit Maharaj was successful. Gokarni Maharaj arranged the success of Dundukari also. Arranged the success of Father who? Atmadev. That day I was quoting one sloka, na? You forget? That day I was quoting one sloka from the glorification of Bhagavat. Nacha Indra Sashukam. This sloka I was speaking. That day I was speaking that nothing permanent in this world. All, you know. So sukham asti virakta samune rekanta jivinaha. Nacha Indra Sasukham. Nacha Indra Sasukham. Kinchinna sukham chakravartinaha. You think that king of heaven is very happy? Indra, not happy. He is also in miserable situation. Nobody happy. They are also in trouble. Nacha Indra Sasukham. Kinchinna sukham chakravartinaha. Chakravartinaha, plural. Those who are chakravarti, Raj Chakravarti. Big, big king, have sovereignty, have total control, sovereignty over whole world. They are also, no, Gaya-raj. Gaya-raj, you know, Gaya-raj. You know, who happy? They are also in trouble. They are never happy. Yudhishthira Maharaj, also crying. Krishna, I only want you. I don't want kingdom. I don't want enjoyment, nothing. I want nothing. Only want your kippa. This is the demand. So this way you have no idea, direct feeling about what is called death. If you can feel it right now, then you can stop thinking about material thing. Anyway, I'm going away. What I can do with property, why I'm going to make relation with this material world. Okay, if at all you are going to stay in this society, somehow you will have to make some relation, but that should be one kind of drama. One Vaishnava father always keeping relation with son, daughter, everything, all drama. And no, nothing permanent. So relation you will have to make, but you should think all unstable. So what about the small boy? The small boy have no idea about what is called actual death. When the maid servant, your Tommy gone. Gone? Where gone? I can find out. When the boy coming to home, he calling Tommy. But Tommy, he think Tommy sleeping. He's calling. You don't understand, Tommy not getting out. Ultimately, they are going to throw Tommy into garbage. Then the boy says, where is my Tommy? I am not going to take any food, milk, nothing. First I like to see my Tommy, then I can eat. Because he is growing his habit to take with Tommy. He is eating, giving some Tommy. This way. So, Gita, Srimad Bhagavad Gita, you will have to hear under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava, you can get actual meaning. 100% human science. 100% human science you can find. Not false. Not false. Many are direct evidence. You know. You can get. So there we can prove that if you are going to grow relation you know, with this material things and money, position, this, that, ultimately you are going to lose devotion. Devotion you cannot get. Now, this is the miserable situation I am speaking about, this bonded soul. What is the constituent of bonded soul? I can discuss next day. This is the situation of bonded soul. The only solution there, if you can start actual devotion. If you can start actual devotion, pure devotion. I have nothing. Only property I have, the lotus feet of Krishna. The lotus feet of Krishna is the only property I have. If you think that way, then you can go out of Maya, you can say. Then otherwise not. Ami to tomar, tumi to amar. Ami to tomar, tumi to amar. Ki kaj aparadhane. O Supreme Lord, you are my property. I am your property. What property I can arrange in my life, or unstable life? So first of all, you should grow this idea, actual scientific idea, about what is called relativity, relative life. You will have to kiss your grandson. I am not speaking you can throw, but you can remember unstable. That baby, maybe in future going to put me in trouble. One incident I can speak. One practical example I can speak. Countless examples I can speak. Go on speaking. One example. In Assam, I heard it from Bharati Maharaj, Bhaktivigan Bharati Maharaj. Bhaktivigan Bharati Maharaj, his Gurudev, my Shiksha Guru. Bharati Maharaj speaking, in Assam, one very poor Brahmin, one very poor man, took some money, lent some money from his friend. That friend is pure Brahman. He is not Brahman, he is a Vaishya. He is Vaishya. Vaishya, no? There is some category. Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Four categories there, as per Vedic culture. Outside there is no category. If they start bhakti, they can become, you know, devotee. So, as per Vedic culture there. So, he was bound to take some money from his friend, who is very pure, nice Brahman. He give me some money because I cannot arrange the marriage of my daughter. I am very poor. So, if you can give some money to me, I can arrange marriage after some time. I can pay you back. Don't worry. Then, after that marriage was done, he took some money from his friend, Len. After some time, marriage is over. Two years over, but he is very poor. He is very poor. He couldn't give. He couldn't give money. He couldn't give money. Follow. This way, that money, he couldn't pay. Then someday, he was bound to die. Because death came in his life, he's dying. Age was not so high, maybe 72 or like that. Because whenever your lifespan is over, then you will have to go away. You cannot say, wait, 5 minutes, I have some. No. Immediately, you have to go. The moment you will have to go away from this world, you will have to go away. There is no compromise. You cannot say, more 2 days I like to live more. No. The time is over, you have to go. Then the friend gone from life, he couldn't pay back the money to that Brahmin friend. After some time, he took birth in the form of lollipop. In the house of that Brahman, outside, staying outside home, that dog is always staying there. And he came in dream, the father came in dream, and speaking to son, oh my son, you can remember, I took loan, money, from my friend, Brahman. I couldn't pay. So now I'm bound to take birth as a lollipop here. So if you pay money, then I can die. I can get respite. Follow? This way, when the money was totally given back to that Brahman, then... But one miracle, one excellent thing is that the son already, you know, watching the dream. Father came in dream and speaking, I am in the form of lollipop, dog, there. But the son not going to take care of that lollipop, not speaking, he is my father. Whereas the father already coming in dream and speaking, I am your father. I took birth as a dog there. But now that son not going to take care of that dog, not speaking, he is my father. Because the relation was relative relation. That with that body, the son having relation with father and son. But the dog is father, the same Jivatma. But the son is not going to take care of that dog. Because his dog. They say, all jang jang baupi saranam bhavam tajiti andi kalivaram. There is a formula. Be careful. Now this is the miserable situation of all born this soul. Countless Jivatma. Countless. Conscious, super conscious, low conscious, not at all conscious, conscious totally gone down. Inert matter, like stones and you know. Inert. Consciousness gone. According to your present activities, you are going to take birth next life. Maybe if you are going to make some wrong activities, you can take birth as tree. Tree, you know? Those trees, they have their consciousness. You have to take. Jamal Arjun, you know? Jamal Arjun from Bhagavatam, they're making mistake. Naraji curse. Foolish. We are doing this way. Go and take birth as Arjun Vikha, Jamal Arjun. And in Dapar Yuga, when Krishna coming there, in the courtyard of Nanda Baba, then you can get respite by the mercy of Krishna. Stay there, foolish you are. Then they took birth. Jamal Arjun for a long time. When in Dapar Yuga, when Krishna came, Krishna, remember that my devotee Indra giving curse, I have my responsibility to rescue these two trees. When the two trees was broken by Krishna, bam, broken. I already told in Bhagavatam, you have gone through, I think. This tree here, Krishna, very small boy, very small, crawling. And he was fitted with one wooden log, I mean, Udukhal. The small boy crawling, he was, you know, tied up with rope, with that log. The small boy gone from in between the space of these two trees. And when Krishna gone, the log only stuck up. Gapping is so. Krishna gone. And the log stuck up. The Krishna pulling. And the two trees, tam, break down. And the small coward boys, they watching two very nice, you know, beautiful, handsome, very nice, two like gods coming out and praying to Krishna. When Nanda Baba, all senior devotees asking, hey, what happens? How these two old trees, very powerful, how fall is your son Gopal? Gopal? Yes, Gopal gone through this in between the space and it push and blah, useless. A small boy, very small boy, how is possible? They don't believe. They say, yes, we find two gods coming out of these trees and praying to Krishna. That prayer is also there in Bhagavatam. They are coming out of the trees and praying to Krishna. Krishna, today you save me, save us. That prayer is there in Bhagavatam. So Jamalacho. So the more you are going to grow your consciousness, the more you are going to grow your consciousness, the more you can get in touch with Supreme Lord, Divinity. I mean spirituality. You can go this way. So now you see what Jiva Goswami was speaking. Today is the disappearance of the day of Jiva Goswami Pad. About countless Jivatma, what Jiva Goswami was speaking, we can go on discussing from Sandarbha. I can discuss. Now today is the disappearance day of Jiva Goswami Pad and Jagadish Pandit. First I like to touch Jagadish Pandit. I can speak more about Jiva Path because he was the both of them very important to me, but time is not sufficient, limited time. Within that time limit, I think I will have to touch the transcendental life, I mean Siddhanta, both of them. Actually, Jagadish Pandit in Gaur Leela, Jagadish Pandit is the eternal parshad of Gauranga. And in Radha Govinda Leela, he is Chandrahas Sakhi. Chandrahas. In Radha Govinda Leela, his identity, Chandrahas Sakhi in Radha Govinda Leela. And his Gaur Leela is Jagadish Pandit. Jagadish Pandit, his house was there just near of Jagannath Mishra's house. One day, Gopal, who Gopal? Gaur Gopal, crying. And non-stop crying. Hey, what you want, boy? Why you are crying? Not speaking. And they are kissing, taking pacify that boy. That boy not stopping crying. Crying and crying. What you want? Stop, stop, don't cry. If you can get boga, they're in the house of, they already they cook and offer to Krishna, Salgram. They're in the house of Jagadish Pandit in Ekadashi day. If you can get that, boga, then I can stop. The small boys, the senior devotees are thinking, how possible the small boy, how no? They're cooking nice prasadam there. In Ekadashi, they are offering to a small boy here and all. They go and speaking to Jagadish Pandit, our small boy crying, I want to get you all your bhoga. What you offer to Krishna today? Nice dal, chapati, chana rasa, everything. A small boy crying, you have to give all prasadam. Jagadish Pandit, okay, well, very good. You can take. That was Ekadashi day. So Ekadashi, it's not applicable for Radharani. Ekadashi is not applicable for Lalita Vishakha. Ekadashi is not applicable for whom? Gaur Gopal. Krishna can do Ekadashi? What do you think? Krishna going to do Ekadashi? Arey, Maharaj, Lalita Vishakha, Radharani, they need not do Ekadashi. When? They are coming in the form of devotee. They are falling. Like Surup Sanatan, Rupa Goswami Pad in the form of Rupa Manjari. Sanatan Goswami in the form of Lavanga Manjari. Eh? So they need not follow Ekadashi. When they are in the form of Sanatan, Rup, Jiva Pad, they will have to follow Ekadashi for them, to show us the way how to do bhajan. They are showing us. In Vrindavan, there is big fighting. Some groups saying, you can offer tulsi to Gurudev while you are offering bhoga to Gurudev. Somebody, no! Why? We are not offering to Krishna. Fighting with each other. They ask me, I say, to put tulsi is more practical. Why? We are offering to Gurudev. Okay, you are offering to Gurudev. But Gurudev never going to take anything without offering to Krishna. With this mood, it is good that you, then they stop. They're fighting with Jija. Even if you are going to offer to Gurudev, still you will have to give Tulsi because Gurudev never want to take anything what you offer without offering to Krishna. Follow. With this mood, you will have to offer Tulsi. So it's an unnecessary fighting actually. So this Jagadish Pandit have his eternal existence in Navadip Dham as Jagadish Pandit in the Leela, direct Leela of, you know, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, and this Jagadish Pandit having his eternal future there in Vrindavan in Chandrahas Sakhi. So now actually Jagadish Pandit went to take darshan of Jagannath. And watching Jagannath with full heavy heart, with tears rolling down his cheeks, watching Jagannath, hey Prabhu. After that, Jagannath came in dream. Jagannath speaking to Jagadish Pandit, Jagadish, I like to go with you. You like to go with me? How? It's not possible. Yes, I can go with you. Follow. Because Jagannath, after 12 years, they are going to change Kalevar, you know. It's also a nice kind of Leela. You cannot make any head or tail. You cannot make any head and tail of this Leela. It's 18 years after. It was some, Kalevar was changed. 18 years after, 18 years before. And now, so Kalevar not always change. Usually they are changing Kalevar after 12 years. Follow. For 40 years in South India you can find Bharadraj, Adi Bharadraj in South India, sleeping inside water for 40 years. After 40 years you will have to point out that tithi. Then Bharadraj can give darshan for one day. After 40 years, just maybe 6 months or 8 months, I forget, some devotee speaking. Then all prime minister and everybody running to take darshan. After 40 years, crores of people coming to take darshan. And for 40 years, Bharadra Adi Bharat staying inside water, sleeping inside water. Supreme Lord is the arrangement of Supreme Lord. Follow. There is 4 gates. One gate they cannot open. If they want to open, who is going to open? He can die. Garur mantra. Out of Garur mantra, they can only open that door. If somebody want to open that door forcefully, then his whole family member, everything can die. Now in Kalika, that kind of pure Brahman is rare. We can speak Garur mantra, Siddha can speak. Then and only then can Garur and that gate can open. That gate is still closed today. Long time, nobody can open. If somebody can try to open, can die. His father, mother, son, wife, all can die. Follow, develop cancer, big problem. Miracle, brother was there. So this way actually, after a long time, so that Kalevar, actually Jagadish Pandit wanted to, Jagannath wanted to go away. So how to take? Jagannath is heavy. Jagadish Pandit is speaking, how I can carry you? Why you can take me where you are staying? How I can carry? You are so heavy. No! If you can fit me, tie me on the head point upon stick and take like umbrella. You are so heavy. No. If you can tie me with one in stick in the head point and you can carry here, Oh, really? No. Jagadish Pandit, Thai Jagannath, and when wanted to put on it, it is like air bubble. Like air bubble, so light. Like air bubble, so light. But one condition, if you put me anywhere, I cannot go. I can stay there. Jagannath speaking, I can go with you. But if you can put me anywhere, I cannot go. I cannot move. I can stay there. Like Shakshi Gopal, you know? I cannot move. Giriraj Maharaj also, I already told. Giriraj Maharaj. Putting condition, Pulasurishi. If you put me in mouth, I cannot go. Be careful. Okay, I have that much power to carry you to Varanasi. Okay, you do. Krishna is having full willpower with him. When Jagadish Pandit is coming at the bank of Ganga, it's called Chakradaha Chagda. You hear the name of Chagda? Don't know? Foolish. Chagda is there, very important place. Chakradaha is called. Chakradaha. And a wheel of Bhagirath was down and this was stuck up. The wheel of Bhagirath, chariot of Bhagavat, Bhagirath, stuck up there. That is called Chakradaha. Chak in Bengali Sanskrit, Chaka. Chakrabat. Chakra, you know? Chakradaha is called in Sanskrit. Daha. At the bank of Ganga. Hey, then Jagadish Pandit thought that I am almost near Navadip Dam. Okay, I can put Jagannath here and take bath in Ganga. Very nice place. Today is very nice, Tithi. I can then put Jagannath there, taking bath and chanting, earning everything. After going to take Jagannath. Jagannath now become Vishambhar. Very happy. Now Jagannath not moving. I already told you, I'm not going to move if you put anywhere. Like in Puri, you know, Puri, Purushottam Khetra, Jagannath. There, at the time of Mahaprabhu, Raja Patabruddha wanted to pull rath, chariot not going. Big elephant, mad elephant coming to pull the chariot. The pool not going even 1 inch. Not going. Because Jagannath like to stay here. Any amount of power we apply, you cannot come out successful. Jagannath speaking, I like to stay here. Then Mahaprabhu coming and speaking, what to do? Chariot not going. Okay. The devotee speaking, Mahaprabhu himself Jagannath, and he also sitting in the form of Jagannath in chariot. The devotee speaking, let us try, you are totally failure, you king, let us try. Then Mahaprabhu going backside of Jagannath chariot and pulling by head. And all devotees, they are doing sankirtan and pulling chariot. The chariot running like wind. Everybody surprised. This chariot not going. 5, 10, mad elephant, powerful elephant. Failure. Mahaprabhu, let me see what Jagannath want. Then Mahaprabhu, with all devotees, Mahaprabhu going backside of the chariot, pulling its head, and the chariot running like wind. Sivishambhar. So Jagannath speaking to Jagadish Pandit, I like to stay here, it is Chakradaha, special place, to give darshan to everybody. Specially, Jagannath taking the form of Jagannath to give you darshan all the time. So Jagannath now staying in the form of in Chagda temple, Jagadish Pandit bring that. And wife name of wife of Jagadish Pandit was Dukhinima. Dukhinima. She used to love Gaur Gopal so much, so much. You cannot believe. Dukhinima used to love Gaur Gopal so much, you cannot believe from heart. Oh, heavy. So Krishna or Gauranga Mahaprabhu always speaking. Actually, I am sold to you. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking? What Krishna speaking? Actually, I am sold to you. I am sold to you because you love me. Out of love, you already buy me. So I am sold to you. This is the formula of Krishna. So, ananyaschintayanto ye yanamam parjubhasate tesam nittabhi yuktanam yogokhyam abhamyaham is 100% perfect. If you are 100% dedication, then you can see everything arranged by Krishna. I already told about Guru Maharaj, na? Are today's bhandara? Nothing, no sabji, no, nothing there. Bharati Maharaj, Narottama Bhamajari. Maharaj, today your bhandara, where is pot? Well, nothing there. Baba, way, everything can come. No rice, no dal, no sabji, nothing. Today you are going to bhandara, nothing is there, no arrangement. Guru Padma Bhakti, Guru Maharaj speaking, way, Baba, you can get everything. Within 1 hour, all rice, you know, dal, ghee, all big pots are coming. Bhakti Maharaj speaking, in my whole life, I have not seen that kind of big bandana. But Bhakti and Bharati Maharaj told, the kind of bandana I never saw. All, you know, Bharati Maharaj speaking, all my Guru Varga taking prasadam, and doing jaykara, you know, prasada seva kuritya sakal, you know, all jaykara, Bharati Maharaj speaking, in my whole life never seen. For half an hour, jayadhani going on. Sarira abhidya jal, jarendiya taikal, jibe phele vishay sagare, tar madhye jivahuti, lobomay sudurmati, tahi jeta kotina sangsare, Krishna mara daya moy, koribare jiva joy, sab prasad anna dila bhai, se anna mita pao, Radha Krishna guna gao, Pemidako Chaitanya Nitai. Foolish. You are thinking prasadam without jaykara, nothing. Nothing you are doing. Only taking in plate, sitting here, and started taking. You have to do jaykara. Prasadam. Follow what I say. So Jagadish Pandit this way. Jagannath came here. Near. From here only. 40 kilometers from here, Chagda. There Jagannath is there, Jagadish Pandit. So this way, if I go on speaking about Jagadish Pandit, is a big thing. So now I like to discuss something about Jiva Goswami. Though time cannot permit, they are also going away today. So with direct realization, you will have to go away from here, not going away. If somebody will be Gaur Kishar Babaji Maharaj speaking, Gaur Kishar Maharaj, somebody coming to pay Dandavat. Babaji Maharaj, I am coming here for in Dham to take darshan of this. And I am going back 3 days after. Gaur Kishar Maharaj was laughing. When somebody coming to Dhamma, they are not coming with return ticket. Dhamma one time, once you coming into Dhamma, Dhamma can love you and bless, you know, embrace you. You cannot go away from. I can go away from Dhamma. If you kill me, I cannot go. I like to stay here. You would like to beat me, kill me. I cannot go. I like to stay here. So, loveful Dhamma. Ganga Jumunas. So, Gaur Kishar Rajma laughing, thinking, I never heard anybody coming into Dhamma with return ticket. Is the first time I am hearing in my life, oh, nobody coming with return ticket in Dhamma. So you will have to stay in Dhamma forever, life after life, to enjoy. the love of Krishna and Gauranga. Eh? Okay. Now, Jiva Goswami path, I like to touch some point because time cannot permit. Someday I can discuss what Jiva Goswami was speaking about all Jiva. All bondage about Jiva, what Jiva Goswami was speaking. I can discuss some point after some time from Sandarbha. Now, Jiva Goswami path was the last Rajpatra of Vishwa Vaishnava Sabha. Is the Rajpatra of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasabha to execute the order and discipline maintained by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, shown by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sarva Gosai, all gone. Only building and temple, sweet ball and enjoyment. Nothing left. Nothing left, all gone. The vitals of Hari Bhajan, all day by day, going away. Painful situation created. I cannot believe. Sriva Goswami Pad was the last, executive member, executor, Rajpatra, through which all rules and regulation can be effective in the whole society. Hey, what you are doing? Now, whole society in the world, they are doing like crazy. He is doing like crazy, he is doing. Nobody going to follow Jiva Goswami path, Rupa Goswami path. The main thing in Hari Bhajan is to show your submission. Main vital thing. No submission there, no bhajan there. No bhajan there. So, if you are not going to follow Jiva Goswami path, I say only the purpose of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasabha was to maintain the quality of Vaishnava society. The main objective of Vishwa Vaishnava Rasabha was to maintain the quality, performance, you know, rules and regulation. You are not allowed to do all rubbish. You are sannyasi, you are doing all rubbish. Why you have taken sannyas? No! Rules and regulation. If father not going to take care of son, the son can become crazy. These are rules and regulation. Follow? In our childhood also, strict regulation. Hey, what you are where you are going? For playing? No, sit. Now read. After half an hour, you can go to field. Otherwise, father used to beat heavily. Heavy beating. Never mother beating to you. Mother used to beat. Because they are beating also one kind of love. You know, when father, mother beating son, well, also one kind of love, you know. So this way, Jiva Goswami Pad was the last member of Vishwa Vaishnava Sabha. And Jiva Goswami Pad following Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami Pad is, you know, Shiksha Guru and Guru properly. The life. You cannot even imagine what kind of big excellency was there with Jiva Goswami path. The topmost Pandit, the topmost Pandit in the whole world. In the whole world, Jiva Goswami path was topmost Pandit. Today I can touch one or two points through which you can understand what is Siddhanta. How we can love Guru Vaishnava, one or two Siddhanta. Even Sanatana Goswami Pad, Rupa Goswami Pad. Rupa Goswami Pad is a disciple of Sanatana Goswami Pad. Jiva Goswami Pad is a disciple of Rupa Goswami Pad. You don't understand. This way, but still, when Rupa Goswami Pad, Sanatana Goswami Pad writing any books, they are giving order to Jiva Goswami Pad to rectify. You see the excellency. So high excellency, you see. This kind of excellence. Whenever writing any book, giving order, you can check, rectify. Tattva Pradeep, one book written by whom? Vallabhatta. He wanted to show that book to Jivapath. Follow? Jivapath gone through this book and pointed out there is not perfection. First of all, I already told, Vallabhatta have great, I am big Pandit, speaking to Rupapath. What book you are writing? Rasamis. Well, after the book is complete, I can edit that book. Jivapath was there. He was, you know, using the seva, hand fan to Gurudev. Gurudev writing, and disciple Jiva Goswami playing hand fan. Long ago, not 500 years ago. Then actually Vallabhatta came. Jivapath paying dandavat. What book you are writing? Actually Rasamrita. Okay, I can edit that book. Oh my God, Rupapada is the eternal parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord. How dare you can speak like this way? You like to edit that book? What kind of fault can be there so that you have the chance to rectify that book? But Rupapada said, okay, well, I'm very lucky you are going to rectify me. Because humbleness, softness and humbleness is the basic thing of your Hari Bhajan. The more you can become humble, to procedure, I can touch. And I can say, Achinta Vedavet Tattva I can touch only. I cannot speak in details. So, actually there is two procedures. One is, by your own power you like to get the feeling of Supreme Lord. Another is that, you can say, oh Supreme Lord, I am very teeny soul. I have no power. If you want to bless me, then I can know something about you. Two procedure. One is ascending procedure, one is descending procedure. One is ascending procedure, out of my own power, I can know what is Brahma. Another procedure, oh, I am very humble, I am fallen soul, I don't know. Please, you bless me. These two procedure. So, usually those Goswamis, they have humble mood. We have nothing, we are actually fallen soul. They are topmost by speaking, oh, you are all fallen soul, we have nothing. Oh, Supreme Lord. So, Rupapada also speaking, well, I am very lucky if you like to rectify that book, okay. You like to edit that book. Then Jiva Goswami Pad was there. After that, you know, Vallabhatta gone to Jamuna to take bath. Jiva Pad also took permission from Gurudev. I can go to take water. Water is, you know, no water there from Jamuna. Well, you can go. With a pitcher, Jiva Goswami going and, you know, following backside. He gone already to take bath. That boy, I mean Jiva Goswami following, where he's going. After that, he paid dandavat and praying. Excuse me, if you never mind, what kind of fault do you have seen in the books of my Gurudev, so that you wanted to edit? Well, who are you? No, I was there. I am disciple, servant of my Gurudev. I am praying to you to know what kind of fall you have seen at all, that you wanted to rectify that book. Then, one by one, Jiva is speaking one argument, Jiva is speaking another. Ultimately, when the small boy went on giving different kind of argument, then that great Pandit, Vallabhatta, gone mad. How possible? The small boy having this kind of great, you know, power. He was just ashamed. Ashamed, you know? He was just ashamed. After that, Jiva coming back to Gurudev, putting water pot and started in Noon Seva. And Vallabhatta, while going back from, after taking bath, he is going back, again entering the Bhajan Kutir of Rupapada. Actually, who is he, that boy? Actually, he is staying here, actually. He is the Anupam, he was my brother, previous ashram. When I was at home, Anupam was my brother, younger brother, he is the son of that. Oh, well, nothing speaking, gone. Then Rupabhad, very intelligent, started putting question to Jivabhad. What happens? What happens? Because already Ballabhattu saw, already Ballabhattu by now is still speaking, you need not edit that book. It's okay. Then Rupabhad speaking, just a few minutes before speaking, wanted to edit my book. Now speak. He's very intelligent. What you speak to him? What you speak to him? I only request him, what kind of fault you have seen in the books of my Gurudev, so that you wanted to... Why you speak like that? His senior devotee, he want to bless me. Go away from me! I don't like to keep you with me. But on behalf of Jiva Goswami Pad, it was perfect. If somebody going to insult my Gurudev, if somebody going to insult your Gurudev, you will have to act like a dog. Go. You will have to. The duty of dog is to protect a master. So, Amito Takur, Tumito Takur, Amito. Tumito Takur, Tomar Kukur, Bolia Jano Homure. Tumito Takur, Tomar Kukur, I am your servant, I am your god, I am your dog. This is the situation. So, Jivapad has done rightly. So, but Gurudev not going to tolerate because he is expressing some kind of, you know, this is allowed in Shastra. If somebody is going to insult Gurudev and Vaishnava, you will have to protest. Why you insult? But Rupa Goswami was so humble that you go away from me. I cannot allow you to stay with me. Then without prasadam, without water, almost for 3 weeks gone, he is crying. And staying therein, at the bank of Jamuna, there is one spot is in Baigaon. All Brajavasis, you know, they request him to take water, milk, everything. No. Then Sanatana Goswami Pad was passing through that village. All the village man, Brajavasis speaking, there is one nice devotee coming. He's not taking in water, you know, milk, nothing, only crying. Who? How looking? Oh my God, this must be Jiva. He's watching. Oh, Jiva, you are here? Yes, I am here. Because Gurudev kicked me away. Why? What problem? This was the situation. Come with me. Let me go to your Gurudev with you. And catch Jiva and coming to Rupapad. First of all, in front of Rupapad, when Sanatana Goswami coming, Sanatana Goswami, Rupapad paying Dhanavad, he is also paying Dhanavad. But after that, Sanatana Goswami putting first question, Jivedaya, this thing, we can find in dictionary, Vaishnava dictionary? What do you mean? No, I mean, Jivedaya, this term, can stay in the book itself, not in application? What do you mean? I mean, that Jivedaya, this term can stay, to show mercy to Jiva, this term can stay in dictionary, Vaishnava dictionary, not in applied form? What do you mean to say? What Jiva path done? What problem? Then Jiva crying, backside. What problem he has done? What mistake? What apparatus? It is the duty of disciple to protest if he finds somebody going to insult Gurudev. So he has done, executed his own duty. He has done his own duty. Then again, he started saying with Gurudev, Jiva Goswami Pad is the topmost Pandit in the whole world. Topmost Pandit. I don't like to touch so many things, time cannot permit. Achinta Vedavat Tattva Vigyan, he illustrates in a very decorative way, very nicely. With Supreme Lord, we have Achinta Vedavat Tattva. Not only that, all infinity world, infinity Jivas, we have our Achinta Vedavat Tattva. Achinta means inconceivable. You cannot even calculate your brain. Achinta Vedavat Tattva, at the same time, you know, you cannot, you know, apply your brain to understand. Achinto, inconceivable, but it's possible. How Mayavad is speaking? You know, this tattva, what is called? Advaita. And they are speaking Dvaita, Advaita, Advaita tattva. And how we, Gaudiya Vaishnava, under the guidance of Jivapath, I mean, actually, by the order of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we are going to maintain this thing, Achinta Vedavat tattva. Advaita Vadi, they want to speak, there is nothing. Only one tattva is there. But Vaishnava, they are speaking, no. There is one and single tattva, we are agree. As per Bhagavatam, there is one and single tattva, right. But still, diversity is there. Follow? Diversity must be there. Diversity, infinity diversity. But they say there is no diversity, it's all illusion, like Maya, nothing. So Vaishnavas, they are speaking that there is Advaigantata. But still, the Advaiganta, within this Advaigantata, there is countless diversity. Yes, it's one kind of decoration. Why you speak like follow this way. So Advaigantata means, if the Mayavad is speaking, if we agree, there is another tattva that is Maya. Jogamaya or Mahamaya? Illusion, Maya. Illusion means Mahamaya. And this Maya, actually pure Maya, is not illusion. Jogamaya, Mayavad, they think if we agree Shakti, if we agree Shakti, Shakti tattva, energy tattva, then is Advaita, and Advaita tattva we cannot establish. So Shakti is not possible. But we Gaudiya Vaishnava always, Jiva Goswami already giving the document, Shakti, Shakti, Mator, Abhed. With Shaktiman, you have your power, na? You have some power, that's why running, doing. That Shakti, that power is there resting in you, not outside. So Supreme Lord is there, with Supreme Lord, Shakti is always there, inside Him. The only difference is there, that we can see in the form of beautiful Radharani. But your Shakti, you cannot show in the form of one, because here all Jivatma, they are Shakti Tattva. Maybe she is your wife, but it is actually, Jivapath speaking, all Jivatma, there is no category, male or female, no category. Jivatma, going out of body, having no category, all same. But still Shakti Tattva. And Shakti, Shakti Matar Abhed, with Shakti, Shaktiman, Supreme Lord is non-different. This Tattva, I can prove and I can go on discussing all about Jiva Tattva in more details. What Jiva Goswami was speaking about the eternal feature of all Jiva, they are permanent in His eternal world or not, or I can try to give argument, try to give answer by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, day by day. I'm not going to speak anything of my own Siddhanta. Siddhanta means? All. So this way I like to stop today, time cannot permit. Vāñśa-kalpa-tarvasya-kipāsindh-bhyavacho-patitānaṁ pāvana-bhyavaśnabhyo Jāṅga brahma varunenda ruddha maruto stunvanti dihibvai stavai vedai saṅga padakrama panishadai gāyanti yam samagā dhyanāvastita tadgati namanaswā pasvanti yam yoginā yasyantam na viduhu sura suragana devayata asmai namaha vancha kalpadurvasi kipasindh bhavajipati tanam pavana bhavishnabhyo nam.
Maharaj, can you maybe shortly on the answer, what is the difference between, because in some religion we see they have this prayer like to speak with God, and we have like to chant mantra. Can you speak about the difference that someone is saying, I like to speak with God, but there's also, we are chanting the Maha Mantra. So what is the...
I already told, you cannot remember. Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told to chant Harinam and to meet Krishna, all the same. But you forget. Remember, I told you, na? But you forget. To chant Harinam and to speak with Krishna, to do same, all same. Meet with Krishna. And those who are speaking, we are talking with Supreme Lord. What is their situation? First, let me know. Bonded soul cannot get in touch with Supreme Lord. How they can talk? Bonded soul can never talk with Supreme Lord. They are in bonded condition. They cannot get in connection. He is Supreme Lord, super consciousness. Your consciousness is nothing. If you cannot come up to that level, in which level? If you are going to express full consciousness, follow what I mean to say. When a bonded soul can grow full consciousness, then he can talk with Supreme Lord. Follow? Then you can talk with Supreme Lord. Otherwise not. How is it possible? Bhaktivinoda Thakur can talk with Krishna. Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Prabhupada can talk with Krishna. Vallabha Bhatta is the picture is there. Ultimately, when Vallabha Bhatta enjoying the full kippa of Mahaprabhu, ultimately changing mood. After that we have seen Sinadji. I have picture, I can show you. Sinadji, deity, and Vallabha Bhatta, you know, kissing each other. Embrace, I have picture. I have picture. The Vigraha, embracing Vallabha Bhatta. And the son of Vallabha Bhatta, who took Vitthalnath, took this, you know, Sinaji, they are in Gujarat. Because that time Muslim, you know, operation was going on, it took. That two chariot is also there, in which Vitthalnath moving, another chariot for Supreme Lord. That chariot broken, is still there. Still there. Where? In, you know, Nathodwar. Two chariot, wooden chariot. They take synergy in all the way in road. Vallabha Bhatta serving, and Vitthalnath serving. Follow this way. I have the picture, so you can talk. You can talk, and about the purity of Mataji's you speak. I can give one or two example. Not today. After some day, I can show you. That in Vrindavan such thing happens. One or two example. Gornitai Pishima, Pishimar Gornitai. Pishima, you know? Paternal aunt. It's called Pishima in Bengali. And maternal aunt is Mashima. You know Mashima? Foolish, don't know. Learning Bengali. Slap you. Pishima, Mashima. That Pishimar Gornitai. Pishima Gornitai, they are in Vrindavan, I can show you. Near Bankhandi, just opposite. Bankhandi gate? Nobody knows. That Gornitai, you know, running in water and, you know, playing all the time. Pishima Bega, hey, you are playing this way, become catch cold. Someday catching cold. Pishima Bega, come here with cloth. Putting here. Eh? Then cleaning the nose of Nitai Gaur. You are laughing, you don't believe. I told you now you can catch cold, now you are going here? Come! This Gaur Nitai is still there. Still there. Pisima was getting special order by Gauranga. You can serve me. Any situation you have in your life, no problem. We are your son? That is rare case. But that is not applicable for all mother, all Matajis. In Vrindavan such thing happens. One Mataji is there serving, you know, Gopal, Bal Gopal, very from heart. Brajavasi Matajis. Some problem there with body, then husband or son helping. That day nobody there. She becomes sick. Oh no. Crying and crying. Who can give boga to Gopal? Gopal cannot take prasadam. Oh, crying, blasted into tears. She wants to die. I cannot serve Gopal. Then from aerial voice came, Mother, you go, you have your cows, Indian cows, Deshi Gomata, already there, now at the contamination. That time all Deshi Gomata. I should not speak that way. That's why that time in whole India there was no contamination. Now contamination. All Indian cows. You go to Goshala and take cow dung and urine and put, you know, like soap, you put on all body. Whole body you go. Urine, and cow urine and cow dung. You mix like soap, you pour whole body. And then you are sick, still you cook, we can take. Follow. So what kind of mental purity is there with that mother? What kind of purity is there with the wife of Chobe? So that Chobe with neem stick. Gopal says, I am very sick. I am very hungry. Then with stick backside, khichdi, making khichdi. But this is not applicable for you. Vidhi marga ratajane sadhinata ratnodane rag marge karaya pravesh. You like to give your uchishta to Gopal, that you can give, but you have to go up to that point. Not a matter of joke. Follow? Huh? So I am going actually. I can give answer. Oof. So I am going.